Good morning students. Today we are going to learn about a lesson, government and taxes. First we will see what is government. A system of social control under which the right to make laws and the right to enforce them is vested in a particular group in society. So a government is the system or a group of people governing an organized community, often a state but also other entities. And tax, the money that you have to pay to the government so that it can provide public service, that is tax. And now we see what are the objectives we have to learn in this lesson. To understand the role of the government and development policies, to gain knowledge about the tax and its types, to study how is tax levied, to gain insight into black money and tax evasion, to know the difference between the tax and other payments, and also to understand the taxes and its development. These are the objectives we have to learn in this lesson. Let's start the introduction of the lesson. Tax is levied by government for the development of the state economy. Levied means collect money. So, tax is collection of money by the government for the development of the state economy. The revenue of the government depends upon direct and indirect tax. These are the two types of taxes, direct and indirect taxes. Direct taxes are levied on income of the person, and the indirect taxes are levied on the goods and services by which the government mobilizes its financial resources. Now we see the topic is role of government in development policy. First one is defense. Defense means security. This is an essential security function to protect our nation from our enemies. We know that we have three services, that is Army, Navy and Air Force. The Union government is responsible for creating and maintaining defense forces to protect our nation from our enemies. This is one of the important development policies in our government. And the next one is foreign policy. A country foreign policy is also called foreign relations or foreign affairs policy. That is consists of self-interest strategies chosen by state to safeguard its national interest and to achieve goals within the international relationships. This approach is strategically employed to interact with other countries. In today's world, we need to maintain friendly relationship with all the other countries in the world. We should also maintain the cordial relationship and also economic relation through export and import, sending or receiving investment and labors. The service is also provided by the Union government. And another one is conduct of periodic elections. The Union government creates law and administrative system and conducts elections to these two legislative institutions. India is a democratic country. We elect our representatives to parliament and state assemblies. Similarly, the state government conducts election to local bodies within the state. And law and order. Both the union and state governments enact numerous laws to protect our rights, properties and to regulate our economy and societies. And public administration and provision of public goods. These services are administered by governments and paid for collectively through taxation. For example, public goods include law enforcement, national defense and also the rules of the law. Public goods also refer to more basic goods such as access to clean air and drinking water. The government generally administers the economy and the society through various departments. For example, revenue department, schools, hospitals, rural development and urban development. The local governments provide public goods like local roads, drainage, drinking water and waste collection disposal, and redistribution of income and poverty alleviations. Governments collect various taxes to finance the various activity mentioned earlier. The taxes are collected in a way that the high income people can bringing in more tax revenue to the government than the poor people. The governments also spend money such as that poor are given some basic necessity of like food, shelter, clothing, education, health care and monthly income to very poor persons. Thus collecting taxes and spending for the poor to reduce poverty, that is pure income redistribution policies, generates less future growth than those policies that expand their economic opportunity of the poor people. But they reduce poverty immediately, they can also alleviate social tensions and may thus free growth constraints in the case of excessive inequalities. And the last one is regulate the economy. The Union Government through the Reserve Bank of India controls money supply and controls the interest rate, inflation and the foreign exchange rate. Their main objective is to remove too much of fluctuation in these rates. The Union Government also controls the economy through various other agencies such as Security Exchange Board of India and Competition Commission of India. All the government of in India run public sector enterprises to provide important goods and services at affordable rates to the people. That is, regulatory economics and the economics of regulations. It is the application of law by government or independent administrative agency for various purposes, including remedying market failure, protecting the environment and economic management. These are all the Union Government also control the economy through various agencies. Like these, all governments in India run the public sector enterprises to provide important goods and services at affordable rate to the people. Now we see a topic is tax. The origin of the word tax is from taxation, which means an estimate. Taxation is a means by which governments finance their expenditure by imposing charges on the citizens and corporate entities. The main purpose of taxation is to accumulate funds for the functioning of the government machineries. Tax has come into forefront on account of the new concept of welfare state. Taxes are compulsory payments to government without expectation of direct returns or benefit to the taxpayer. Professor Seligman also defined as a tax as a compulsory contribution from a person to the government to defray the expenses incurred in the common interest of all without reference to special benefit conferred. Tax is a compulsory financial charge or some other type of levy imposed upon a taxpayer by a government organization into order. Now we see what is tax system. Most countries have a tax system in place to pay for public, common or agreed national needs and government functions. Some levy a flat of percentage rate of taxation on personal annual income, but most scale taxes based on annual income amount. Every type of tax has some advantages and some disadvantages. So we have a tax system that is a collection of variety of taxes. Let's see one by one. First one is canon of equity. Since tax is a compulsory payment, all economists agree that equity is the cardinal principle in designing the tax system. The rich should pay more tax revenue to the government than the poor because rich has more ability than the poor to pay the tax.
The canon of equity or equity implies that the burden of taxation must be distributed equally or equitably in relation to the ability of the taxpayer. That is canon of equity.
And the next one is canon of certainty. The tax which an individual has to pay should be certain and not arbitrary. According to Adam Smith, the time of payment, the manner of payment, the quantity to paid, that is taxability, ought to all be clear and plain to the contribution and to everyone. So the canon of equity means government should announce in advance the tax system so that every taxpayer will be able to collect how much tax amount one may have to pay during a year to the government. And the next one is canon of economy and convenience. If the tax is simple, then the cost of collecting taxes, taxpayer cost plus tax collector cost, will be very low. Further, taxes should be collected from a person at a time he gets enough money to pay the tax. This is called the canon of convenience. A convenient tax reduces the cost of collecting tax. This canon of implies that the cost of collecting a tax should be as minimum as possible. Many tax that involves high administration cost and unusual delay in assessment and high collection of taxes should be avoided altogether. And the last one is canon of productivity and elasticity. A tax is said to be a productive one only when it acts as an incentive to protect. And elasticity is whenever the government needs money, it must be able to extract as much income as possible without generating any harmful consequences through raising tax rates.
The government should choose a tax that can get enough tax revenue to it. It should choose a few tax that can fetch more tax revenue instead of lot of taxes. This is a canon of productivity. The tax is paid by the people out of their income. Therefore, the tax system should be designed in such a way that the people automatically pay more tax revenue if their income grow. This is called canon of elasticity.
Why taxes? The money you pay in taxes goes to many places. In addition to paying the salary of government workers, your taxes dollars also help to support common resources such as police and firefighters. Tax money helps to ensure the road you travel on is safe and well maintained. Tax fund to public libraries and parks. There are two types of taxes,
direct tax and indirect tax. Direct tax, which is levied on the income or profits of the person who pay it rather than on goods and services. A direct tax is a tax an individual or organization pays directly to the imposing entities. For example, pays direct tax to the government for the different purposes including real property taxes, personal and property tax, income tax or taxes on assets. There are some of the taxes coming under the direct tax. Let's see what are the things which you have learned. Income tax. An income tax is a tax imposed on individuals or entities that varies with respective income or profits. Income tax generally is computed as the product of a tax rate times taxable income. Taxation rates may vary by types or characteristics of the taxpayer. The tax rates may increase as taxable income increases. So the income tax is the most common and most important tax levied on an individual in India. It is charged directly based on the income of a person. The rate at which is charged varies depending on the level of income. Next one is corporate tax. The tax is levied on company that exists as separate entities from the their shareholders. It is charged on royalty interest gains from a sale of capital assets located in India and fees for a technical service and dividends. A corporate tax is also called corporation tax or company tax. It is a direct tax imposed by a jurisdiction on the income or capital of corporation entities. Many countries impose such a tax to national levels, and also a similar tax may be imposed at a state or local levels.
And another one is wealth tax. Wealth tax is charged on the benefit derived from property ownership. The same property will be taxed every year on its current market value. The tax is levied on the individual and the company alike. A wealth tax is a tax on a entity's holdings of assets. This includes the total value of personal assets including cash, bank deposit, real estate and asset in insurance and pension plans, ownership of union corporated business and financial security and also a personal.
Now we see indirect tax. An indirect tax is a tax collected by an intermediary from the person who bears the ultimate economic burden of the tax. For example, an indirect tax is collected by one entity in the supply of chain. For usually a producer or a retailer and paid to the government, but is passed on to the consumer as part of the purchasing price of a goods or services. The consumer is ultimately paying the tax by paying more for the product. And if the burden of the tax can be shifted to others, it is an indirect tax. The impact of is on one person while the incidence is on the another person. Therefore, the case of indirect taxes, the taxpayer is not the tax bearer. Some indirect taxes are stamp duty, entertainment tax, exercise duty and goods and services tax. Let's see in detail. Stamp tax. Stamp duty is a tax that is levied on single property purchases or documents. A physical stamp had to be attached to or impressed upon the document to denote the stamp duty. Had been paid before the document was legally effective. More modern versions of the tax no longer require an actual stamp. Stamp duty is a tax that is paid on official documents like marriage registration or documents related to a property and in some contractual agreement also. And now we see what is entertainment tax. Entertainment tax is a duty that is charged by the government on any sources of entertainment provided. This tax can be charged on movie tickets, tickets to amusement parks, exhibitions and even sports events also. Excise duty. Excise duty refers to the tax levied on the manufacture of goods within the country as opposed to customer duty that is levied on goods coming from outside the country. An excise is an any duty on manufactured goods levied at the moment of manufacture rather than its sale. Excise is typically imposed in addition to an indirect tax such as sales tax. And now we see GST. GST means goods and service. The goods and services is one of the indirect taxes. The GST was passed in Parliament on 29th March 2017. The Act came into effect on 1st July 2017. So let's see. GST is an indirect tax used in India on the supply of goods and services. It is the comprehensive multi-stage destination-based tax. Comprehensive because it has subsumed almost all the indirect taxes except a few state taxes. However, tax levied. Tax levied by the government progressively, proportionately, as well as regressively. Proportionate tax rate is one in which the rate of taxation increase multiplier as the tax base increase multiplicand. In this case of the progressive tax, when income increase, the tax rate also increases. Progressive tax refers to the way the tax rate progresses from low and high, with the result that a taxpayer average tax rate is less than the person marginal tax rate. Proportionate taxes. Tax levied on goods and services in a fixed portion is known as proportionate taxes. All taxpayers contribute the same proportion of their income. A proportionate tax is a tax imposed so that the tax rate is fixed, with no change as the taxable base amount increase or decreases. The amount of the tax is in proportion to the amount subject to taxation. And the last one is regressive tax. It implies that higher the rate of tax, lower the income groups. Then in the case of higher income groups, it is a very opposite of progressive taxation. It describes a distribution effect on income or expenditure, referring to the way to the tax progresses from high to low, so that the average tax rate exceeds that the marginal tax rate. We see the topic is black money. Black money is funds earned on the black market on which income and other taxes have not been paid. The unaccounted money that is concealed from the tax administrator is called black money. And let's see what are the causes of black money. Several sources of black money are identified as causes. Let's see what are the causes. First one is shortage of goods. Shortage of goods means a market surplus occurs when there is an excess of supply, that is, quantity supply is greater than quantity demanded. A market shortage occurs when there is an excess of demand, that is, quantity of demand is greater than quantity of supplied. In this situation, consumers won't be able to buy as much of goods as they could like. And the second one is licensing proceeding. That means the administrative and or judicial proceeding described in Annex 4 and any other proceeding by and before a governmental authority in order to challenging in any matter the granting of the license notified to the administrative agent order. And another one is contribution of industrial sector. That means the industrial sector is one of the main sector that contributes to the Indian gross domestic product, that is GDP. The industrial sector is the leading segment that is proceeding employment at the quicker pace than our populate in developing. And the fourth one is smuggling. That means to take the things into or out of the country secretly in a way that is not allowed by the law. To take a person or a thing secretly into or out of a place. And at last one is tax structure. That means the tax base is the amount to which a tax rate is applied. The tax rate is the percentage of the tax base that must be paid in taxes. For example, tax base, tax rate, proportional, regressive and the progressive taxation. And next we will see the topic is tax evasion. Tax evasion is the legal evasion of taxes by individuals, corporation and trust. Tax evasion activities included under-reporting income, inflating deduction or expenses, hiding money, hiding interest in offshore accounts. Tax evasion, that means the illegal non-payments or tax evasion is an illegal activity in which a person or entity de-liability avoiding payments or true tax liabilities. So some of the tax evasion penalties we have to learn below. So tax evasion penalties, like if a person willfully commits the act of tax evasion, he may face penalty charges. Tax evasion penalties include imprisonment of up to 5 years and a high amount as fines. The defendant may also be ordered to pay or the cost of prosecution. And the tax evasion penalties can be harsh depending on the severity of the crime. So, if the taxpayer does not disclose the undisclosed amount but does so in the return of income finished in the previous year, that is 20% of penalty, undisclosed amount along with an interest is levied. If the previous year amount is undisclosed, the minimum penalty that can be levied in 30% and the maximum is 90% of amount we have to pay the taxpayer. Next, we will see the topic is taxes and development. The advice economists have offered to developing countries has changed over time, particularly regarding income and consumption taxes. So some of the role of taxation in developing economics is as follows. Let's see what are they. First one is resource mobilization. Taxation enables the government to mobilize a substantial amount of revenue. The tax revenue is generated by imposing direct taxes such as personal income tax and corporate tax, and indirect tax such as customs duty and excise duty, etc. Resource mobilization is the process of getting resources from the resource provider using different mechanisms to implement on organization's predetermined goals. And the next one is reduction inequalities of income. Taxation follows the principle of equity. The direct taxes are progressive in nature. Also, certain indirect taxes such as taxes on luxury goods is also a progressive in nature. Reduction inequalities are within and among countries. Too much of the world wealth is held by a very small group of people. This is often leads to financial and social discrimination also. Next one is social welfare. Taxation generates social welfare. Social welfare is generated due to higher taxes on certain undesirable products like alcoholic products. And another one is foreign exchange. Taxation encourages exports and restricts imports. Generally, developing countries and even the developed countries do not impose tax on export tax items. And another one is regional development. Taxation plays an important role in regional development. Tax incentives such as tax holidays for setting up industrial in backward regions, which includes business firms to set up industries in such regions. For example, if the provisions of aid and other assistance to regions which are less economically developed, and also the regional development may be domestic or international in nature. And last one is control of inflation. Taxation can be used as an instrument for controlling inflation. Through taxation, the government can control inflation by reducing the tax on commodities. That is the control of inflation. Inflation means a rise in prices. One popular method of controlling inflation is through a contractionary monetary policy. The goal of a contractionary policy is to reduce the money supply within an economy by decreasing bond price and increasing interest rate. These are all the role of taxation in developing economics.
And now we see difference between tax and other payments. Tax. Taxes are compulsory to the government without getting any direct benefits. Payments. Fee is a payment for getting any services. Tax. If the element of revenue for general purposes, state predominates, the levy becomes a tax. Payments. While a fee is a payment for a specific benefit, privilege, although the special to the primary purpose of regulations in public interest. Tax is a compulsory payment. Fee is a voluntary payment. If tax is imposed on a person, he has to pay it, otherwise he has to penalized. On the other hand, fee is not paid if the person do not want to get the services. In this case, taxpayer does not expect any direct benefits, for example income tax, gift box, wealth tax, VAT, etc. Fee payer can get direct benefit for paying fee, for example stamp fee, driving license, government registration fee, etc. Students, thank you. In this lesson we have to learn what is tax and what are the types of tax, what is progressive tax, what is regressive tax, and also we learn about what is black money, and also learn about what is tax evasion. Thank you.